Well, thank you very much for joining me here today. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the official process for installing SWPCB, or better known as SOLIDWORKS PCB. And we're also going to go through the process of installing the services. We need to install the services first. What are the services? They're basically the interface that would be used between SOLIDWORKS PCB and SOLIDWORKS CAD. And the reason why you have to have this is because the head revision needs to be controlled. There are different ways of handling the service. If you're brand new to this and you do not have any services already installed, then you are going to install it onto your machine. If you've purchased a number of these licenses and you're going to have a services that everybody's going to use, then what you want to do is get your IT person involved. And if you already have an Altium Vault, that can serve as the services. Okay, so I want to make that clear before we continue on here. What we're going to do here is we're first going to install the services. But before I go into all the installation procedure, what I want to show you and what you're seeing on the screen over here is what you would typically get from us here at 9.Connects if you've asked for an evaluation. So you can see over here it's going to say that your product evaluation request ID, and you'll be issued one. Your company has been approved. Now, what are they going to give you? Well, it depends on what you've asked for. But for the most part, what you're going to want is the SOLIDWORKS PCB. You may not get the PCB connector, and you may not even get SOLIDWORKS Premium, but you're going to get the SOLIDWORKS PCB. So you want to keep this particular code handy to you, because when you go through the installation process, it's going to ask for it. Now, the very first thing you want to do is you want to download the installation manager. And it's really easy to click on this and let it take care of it for you. If you just happen to have a code because maybe you moved to another machine and you want to install it and you don't remember where your email is, there's another way to do this as well. And you can do it through your internet. And I'm going to show you that over here very quickly. I'm going to bring this up here. You can see that I've logged into the SOLIDWORKS site. And when you log in there, they give you the opportunity to do a download. And you can see the various downloads that they make available. So what I am going to do is I'm actually going to download SOLIDWORKS products. And I'm going to click on that here. And the reason why they say SOLIDWORKS products is because their installation manager can handle different types of products. And that's what's really nice about their installation manager. So in the future, if you actually purchase another SOLIDWORKS product, you don't even necessarily need to go through this again. You just simply need to use the installation manager. And the installation manager will ask you for that code. And from there, it will download and install that additional product that you may have purchased. This over here is simply asking me for the acceptance to your EULA, and I'll continue with that. EULA stands for End User License Agreement. And then from there, I'm just going to simply download it. Now, again, if you had that link, all of this would have been done for you. So this whole process of me downloading this, and you can see the SOLIDWORKS setup.exe, it's going to save it. I'm going to press OK. It's only 28 megabytes. So again, it's just an installation program. It's not the program itself. Once we get into the installation program, then we're going to give it the code, and from there, it's going to download and install it for us. All right, it's now finished, so I'm going to tell it to run at this point in time. Now, what's also going to come up here is the WinSelf self-extractor here, so make sure you do have some type of extraction tool, basically WinZip or 7-Zip or one of those tools that we can unzip this for you. So I'm going to press WinZip and allow this to continue. All right, so it's been unzipped. I'm going to press OK, and now we see the installation manager coming up. This particular window that's coming up over here is asking us about a reboot that is pending. This is just something that tends to come up on its own here. And generally speaking, you can just ignore it. In fact, if we press cancel, we wouldn't be able to get through the rest of the installation anyways. Not necessarily sure what the mechanism is that it's looking for that reboot, but nevertheless, it will work fine as we go along. So I'm just going to press OK to allow this to proceed. So it's going to give us a couple of options. And one of the options is, well, you can see individual on this computer. And this is what we're going to use for SOLIDWORKS PCB. But before we do that, we need to install the server first. So what we're going to do is we're going to go under Server Products, and we're going to install SOLIDWORKS PCB services, not SOLIDWORKS Electrical. That's another product altogether. That one's more of a system level electrical thing that handles cables and harnessing. What we're interested in is SOLIDWORKS PCB services. So I'm going to check that at this point in time. And I'm going to press next. Okay. It's now connecting to SOLIDWORKS, it's checking a serial number, and it's going to update the downloader. There really isn't a serial number per se that goes with this. The serial numbers that you are going to receive are going to go with the SOLIDWORKS PCB. So this is what it's going to download at this point, and this looks fine. And so I'm going to tell it to download and install. Actually, one other thing, if it doesn't do that, make sure you click I accept the terms of the SOLIDWORKS license agreement. And you can read it there if you want to as well. So I'm going to download and install now. You'll notice that on the screen, a SOLIDWORKS installation is scheduled to begin in so many seconds. I suppose I could press the install now. However, I'm going to let it finish its download operations on its own accord, and then I'll let it start when it thinks it's ready. So the download is now complete, and now it is installing the server. You get the option to join the SOLIDWORKS Customer Experience Improvement Program. Feel free to do so if you want. I'm going to simply decline at this point in time, but you do have the option, or I guess in this case, I would have the option to join later on if I so wish to do so. I'm going to press finish at this point, and now it is complete. All right, what I'm going to try to do over here is I'm going to actually see if the services is up and running, and I can do that without SOLIDWORKS PCB being installed in my machine. So what you can see over here is I've got my, I think this is Microsoft Edge that I've got up right now. You can obviously use Chrome or another web browser as well. But I'm going to click here and start a new tab. All right. And what I'm going to put in here is localhost :9780. So that's the port that this server is going to use by default. And just as a side note, 9780 is the only port that the SOLIDWORKS services for PCB can use at this point in time. So if you've got something else on there like the Altium Vault, you do need to contact Dassault to see if there's other ways of handling that. Now, this is a good sign because it immediately came up and it's asked me for a username and password. I'm going to put in my username. The default one is admin, and so is the password. It's all lowercase, and I'm going to press sign in. So it's looking like it's redirecting, and it's showing me the PCB services. Obviously, there's not a whole lot in here, though it's actually finding some information that I had when I had this previously installed, because I can see some information here on my projects. So either I didn't completely uninstall it or I found some old files on my machine, but the fact of the matter is that this is now installed, and that's fine by me. So I'm going to press sign out here, and I'm going to close this or minimize this at this point in time. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to install SWPCB. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to double-click on the setup.exe. This is the installation guide that was downloaded. Initially, it opened up automatically for me, but it was also downloaded and installed on in my downloads directory by default. So make sure you go there and find it. You don't want to double-click on the zipped version of it. You just simply want to use the resulting one, which is the setup.exe. So I'm going to it's going to ask me to approve of that. That's where the chime you heard. Again, we get our infamous Windows reboot is pending. I'm going to press OK and let it continue. In this case, I'm not going to go to server products. I'm going to go to individual on this computer, and I'm going to press next. I am not going to, at this point in time, I'm not going to worry about my SOLIDWORKS here. So I did uninstall this initially so that I could work with a clean slate here, but if I wanted to, I could actually install SOLIDWORKS CAD in addition to these other products if I got all of their license codes at the same time. But for our sakes, I want to simply focus in on SOLIDWORKS PCB. So I'm going to minimize this over here. And if it's not minimized for you or been expanded for you, go ahead and click on Electrical Design. Make sure you select SOLIDWORKS PCB, and then you'll enter your code in here. If you have it in that email, just simply copy it. And then do your control C to copy it. And then if you place your cursor in there and do a control V, it'll put the numbers in accordingly. All right, I'm gonna press next now. And now in this case, because I've uninstalled and reinstalled, I'm gonna get a message of this nature. You won't have to worry about that at this point in time. I'm just gonna press okay to continue. So now it's checking for updates and it's looking around, seeing what's there. And in a moment, it should come back up over here asking me to approve of these things. So there's a number of things that are going to be installed. Obviously, when you're dealing with an interface of this nature, there are some ancillary tools that are necessary for this to work. The key thing that we obviously need is the SOLIDWORKS PCB, and we do see this on the list. The terms of the agreement have been checked off here, so I am going to allow this to download and install. Notice that we're dealing with kind of a big file over here, so this will take a little bit. Okay, so the SOLIDWORKS PCB has now been downloaded and installed. And again, I'm just going to select a no here at this point in time, but you are certainly encouraged to participate in this program if you choose to do so. I'm going to press finish. And now what we're going to do here is I'm going to minimize this particular screen. We don't need that anymore. And I'm going to bring up SOLIDWORKS PCB 2017. The splash screen has come up. I unfortunately cannot drag it over to the screen in which I'm presenting here, but it should come up in full in a moment. I can drag that. So the splash screen is up. That's good. And what we got over here is our request to log in. So it does have our localhost 9780. I'm going to leave it as is. If it doesn't like it, I may remove the HTTP request. I'm going to press login. And that looks fine. And I'm dragging it up here right now. And you can see that over here. So this is what you're going to get. You may also get the storage manager. That's one of the panels that is included with SOLIDWORKS PCB. Feel free to close that if you don't want to use it for now. It does look a little bit bare over here, but these are the very beginnings of SOLIDWORKS PCB. At that point in time, you can always click on File, and you can open documents. So if you have any documents, either from another SWPCB installation or even from Altium Designer, you certainly can open those documents at this point in time. If you're going to create a project, you can also do that. You can click on New PCB Project. And when you do so, one of the things that has to be installed is our services. So it already knows about our repository and those services over there. So it took care of that for you. One final note, when you do open up any of the Altium Designer files, all the extensions will work just fine, except for PCB doc. It needs to be converted to SWPCB doc. And there's a procedure that we have on our website here at 9.connects that will show you how to do it. It's a very easy thing to do, and you'll have no problems opening it thereafter. So hopefully you're now on your way, and I wish you the best in your SWPCB endeavors. Take care.